God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Welcome to Marian Saturday, and happy Feast of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. I'm Lauren, here with the team, and I'm so glad you've decided to start your weekend with us. So as we mentioned a few weeks ago, during her apparitions in Fatima, Our Lady asked that believers partake in the first Saturday's devotion. To learn more about Our Lady of Fatima, check out the video I've linked in the notes. But this first Saturday's devotion is so important and powerful, it really deserves more discussion. So that's what we'll be diving into today. The first Saturday's devotion is a devotion offered in reparation for sins against the Immaculate Heart and in consecration to the Immaculate Heart. It consists of receiving communion, going to confession, praying the rosary, and spending 15 minutes meditating on a mystery of the rosary, all on the first Saturday of 5 consecutive months. You don't have to memorize all that. Check out the link in the notes for all of those details and more. Through Mary's messages in Fatima and many other places throughout the world, she tells us that one day her Immaculate Heart will triumph. She will crush the head of the serpent, and her heart will serve as a place of refuge for all of her faithful children until then. Therefore, she tells us that consecrating ourselves and our families to her Immaculate Heart is one of the most powerful and important things we can do during these times. Whether you've done the first Saturday's devotion before or not, we invite you to start with us as a TGM community on July 6th. And today, we'll be praying a prayer as an act of consecration to the Immaculate Heart of our Blessed Mother. Making this prayer of consecration and living a life consecrated to the Immaculate Heart means becoming an apostle of Mary, striving to imitate her virtues, and placing in her hands the flowers of little sacrifices of reparation for the salvation of souls, so that we might strengthen her hand against the attacks of the evil one, and hasten the day of the triumph of her Immaculate Heart. To be consecrated to Mary and her Immaculate Heart means to entrust all of your intentions to her and to offer your prayers and works for her intentions. It is a really beautiful and freeing thing to be able to just surrender all into her hands, knowing that She knows exactly what you need, and she will present it to her son in the manner that is most in line with God's will. To everyone who makes that consecration and sincerely tries to live it, the words of Our Lady to the child Lucia of Fatima would also apply. I will never leave you. My immaculate heart will be your refuge and the way that will lead you to God. For the prayer we'll be praying today, and for more information about consecrating yourself to the Immaculate Heart, there is another link below that you'll find in the notes. Now, let us bow our heads and pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. O Virgin Mary, most powerful Mother of Mercy, Queen of heaven and earth, in accordance with your wish made known at Fatima, I consecrate myself today to your Immaculate Heart. To you I entrust all that I have, all that I am. Reign over me, dearest Mother, that I may be yours in prosperity, in adversity, in joy, and in sorrow, in health, and in sickness, in life, and in death. I, a faithless sinner, renew and ratify today in thy heart, O Immaculate Mother, the vows of my baptism. I renounce forever Satan, his pomps, and his works. And I give myself entirely to Jesus Christ, the incarnate wisdom, to carry my cross after him all the days of my life, and to be more faithful to him than I ever have been before. Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, in the presence of all the heavenly court, I choose thee this day for my mother. I deliver and consecrate to thee and to thy Immaculate Heart, as thy child and slave of love, my body and soul, my goods, both interior and exterior, and even the value of all my good actions, past, present, and future, leaving to thee the entire and full right of disposing of me and all that belongs to me without exception, according to thy good pleasure, for the greater glory of God in time and in eternity. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Let us glorify our Savior, who chose the Virgin Mary for his mother. Confident that he will hear us, we ask,
may your mother intercede for us, Lord.
Eternal Word, you taught your mother Mary to choose the path that was best.
Let us follow her example and hunger for the food of everlasting life.
May your mother intercede for us, Lord.
Calling to mind all of our intentions, together we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
May Almighty God watch over and protect us in blessing this day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us in prayer, consecrating yourself to the Blessed Mother today. In closing, I'd like to leave you a thought to meditate on. She gave three major blows to hell. The first, with her fiat. The second, with her suffering in unison with her son. And the third, with her unwavering faith in the resurrection. And in culmination, it is she who will crush the head of Satan by the merits of her son's death. It is her Immaculate Heart that will triumph.
Shine on those in time.